BBC News at 7 o'clock on Tuesday, the 5th of July. Good morning, this is Anthony Birchley. BBC News understands the Prime Minister was aware of a formal complaint of inappropriate behaviour by Chris Pincher before appointing him as Deputy Chief Whip. A man has been arrested near Chicago after six people were shot dead at an Independence Day parade. And why a group of scientists are pinning their hopes on sand to help reverse climate change. The BBC has learned that Boris Johnson knew about a complaint raised against the former Deputy Chief Whip, Chris Pincher, while he was a Foreign Office Minister. Downing Street previously claimed that the Prime Minister wasn't aware of any specific allegations against Mr. Pincher when he was appointed in February. The MP was suspended from the Conservative Parliamentary Party last week, having been accused of groping two men. He's denied a series of other allegations about inappropriate behaviour. Our political correspondent Ione Wells has more details about the complaint.
I understand that this triggered a formal process which was led by Cabinet Office officials. Now, this process led to a report confirming his misconduct, which I understand Mr. Pincher apologised for at the time, although he hasn't responded to requests for comment. Foreign Office have said that they have robust measures in place to deal with allegations, but this claim raises fresh questions about why the Prime Minister decided to appoint Chris Pincher.
Police officers in the US state of Illinois have arrested a 22-year-old man who is suspected of shooting six people dead at an Independence Day parade. More than 20 others were wounded in the attack in the suburb of Highland Park, north of Chicago. Robert E. Crimo III was detained after a brief chase. Speaking at the White House, President Biden said he was doing all he could to tackle gun crime.
Before I left for Europe, I signed a law, the first real gun safety law in 30 years. And things will get better still, but not without more hard work together. You all heard what happened today.
A BBC investigation has found that children as young as 11 in the care system have been housed in temporary accommodation, such as Airbnbs, in England and Wales. The record numbers of children needing placements has caused some local councils to struggle to find suitable accommodation, Wira Davis reports.
A BBC Wales investigation using Freedom of Information requests found dozens of children were placed in B&Bs, hostels and budget hotels last year, despite a Welsh Government pledge to end the practice 6 years ago. In England, the last available government figures show that over 6,000 young people were sent to live in places which were not inspected, and the children's charity Become says that many teenagers were left without proper support.
The Welsh Government says it's investing more in foster care and accommodation. In England, the government says reforms will be introduced later this year. The NHS is to start using drones to transport chemotherapy drugs from a pharmacy in Portsmouth to a hospital on the Isle of Wight. It's expected to cut delivery times from 4 hours to 30 minutes and is part of a trial to assess the wider use of drones in the health service. Researchers in Finland have installed the world's first fully working sand battery, which can store green power for months. The device contains 100 tonnes of low-grade sand, which is charged up with heat made from solar or wind. It can then be used to warm homes in winter when energy is more expensive. Here's our environment correspondent, Matt McGrath.
In a town in western Finland, a pump pushes hot air into a large container of builder's sand. These rough and ready grains are surprisingly effective at retaining heat, storing it at very high temperatures for months at a time. The sand-based technology aims to overcome one of the biggest challenges facing renewable energy. In the summer, when solar and wind energy are cheap, electricity is used to warm the sand to around 500 degrees Celsius. The hot silica is then used to warm water for a district heating system when energy prices are higher. The sand battery idea is being seen as a cheap and efficient way of storing the summer sun for use in the long cold winter.
The last remaining British player in the Wimbledon singles, Cameron Norrie, will try to secure a place in the semi-finals this afternoon. He'll meet David Goffin on court number one. Norrie says he's ready for the unseeded Belgian.
He's very experienced and he has a very complete game and really comfortable on the grass, so it's not going to be easy, but I'm going to go out and give it everything and I'm as prepared as I can be.
And the weather, variable cloud and a few spots of rain in Northern Ireland and the south of the UK this morning, with light showers moving into the west of Scotland this afternoon. Dry and bright elsewhere. Temperatures could reach highs of 23 Celsius in London, 20 in Cardiff, 18 in Edinburgh, 17 Celsius in Belfast. That's the BBC News at 7:05.
On the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
Rise and shine!
BBC Radio 2.
Thank you, Anthony. Lovely weather report there. By the way, loving the tennis. I wish I had the confidence of Kyrgios. What is he like? And good luck to Cameron Norrie today. Also, good luck to the Women's Football Trailblazers. They are walking from Crewe, where the first ever Women's Euros happened, to Old Trafford, nearby here, where this year's tournament starts tomorrow. More celebration of the Women's Euros on this show tomorrow. Plus, it's the 20th anniversary of the Imperial War Museum North opening just across the road. We're here in Salford Riviera. The museum, lots of celebrations today. And Prince Charles and Duchess Camilla start their tour around Wales with a visit to BBC Wales' new headquarters. We've been there. It's really rather fabulous.